I'm scared of war because people can come and kill your father or your mother.
We have no news of my mother. I don't know where she is. There were gunshots everywhere. My mother woke me up and told me we had to go. When we arrived at the Masisi Centre, there were huge crowds there.
When these people find you at home, they take everything you have, and if you're unlucky, they come with knives and they tear your body. They cut you to pieces.
At one point in Masisi Center, I lost my mum.
Antoine's story is similar to Esther's and to the stories of tens of thousands of children in North Kivu in the Democratic Republic of Congo, where a 20-year-old conflict has flared up again. Antoine and Esther are displaced, like 750,000 other people in the province. They live in the Kalinga camp in Masisi territory. When the war forced them to flee their homes last October, they lost everything. But this year, they're back in a classroom, thanks to the EU Children of Peace Initiative and the Norwegian Refugee Council, which works to get displaced children back into school and aims to reduce the threats linked to the conflict and the presence of armed groups in the area.
Children are often easy targets for armed groups, and the main risks to them are from forced recruitment by militia. Sometimes they are used to carry out domestic tasks or military ones, so children risk being engaged in the fighting, and for girls especially, they risk ending up as sex slaves.
I was buying and selling little things, and I thought, you know, my parents are dead. Am I just going to go on doing this all my life? So when I saw the others going to school, I went along with them to sign up.
I hadn't been to school for 2 years because my parents didn't have any money. During that time, I went out collecting firewood, which I sold, and the money was used to feed the family. Life really was very hard for me.
The Nema Primary School, where Esther and Antoine go, was burned down last year by militias and rebuilt in February with money from the EU Nobel Peace Prize. Over 500 schools were damaged or destroyed in the past year, but today, this school has more than 600 students. NRC managed to register more than 400 children who had never been to school before, using a condensed education system, catch-up classes, and financial help for the most deprived.
I came to this school because I wanted to change my life.
In the Lucia Berry child-friendly space, up to 2,000 children do various activities and workshops. But it is just a drop in the ocean. Less than 40% of children living in displacement camps are enrolled in an educational scheme. Parents just cannot afford to send their children to school.